I got this Svbony H Alpha filter for about $70 from Facebook Marketplace. I know I'm lucky, these are worth way more than that. Anyways, I thought I would make a quick video to tell you how impressed I am with this filter. This is my first H Alpha filter and I wanted to share how my experience with this filter has been thus far. Let's talk about the specs first. Svbony produces many filters. Well, this filter by Svbony is a narrowband H alpha filter, which means it has a very narrow light pass at a certain wavelength. It blocks almost all of the wavelengths and only allows 656 nm to go through. Now, 656 nm is what is called H alpha wavelength. If you have been doing astrophotography for a long time, you would know that the sky is packed with H alpha. Most nebula targets are H alpha rich. This filter allows you to isolate those wavelengths and capture it. You'll be able to capture all H alpha emitting nebula with this filter. At 7 nm, it's a respectably small bandpass for the price. A lot of similarly priced filters have a wider 12 nm bandpass. Wider is bad, by the way. More sky glow and light pollution, the wider the filter. 7 nm is quite narrow and reasonable in my view. Other companies charge twice the price for 7 nm. This filter uses high quality German glass. It is double-sided and polished. It promises at least 85% transmittance, which is pretty good. This filter has multi-layer anti-reflection coating, and its frame is made with high-quality aluminium alloy material. Overall, I think it feels nice in hand and has a good finish. But let's talk about its uses. Firstly, you can use this to produce narrowband images. If you have other filters, you could create a Hubble palette image which looks awesome. Secondly, you can use this filter when the moon is up. Half of the time we are covered with clouds and the other half of time we've got the moon staring down. You might already know this, astrophotography is almost impossible when the moon is up. But using narrowband filters like this can help you get clean data even on full moon nights. This will allow you to get decent photos when the moon is out and it's clear. I often continue gathering data because of this filter. Thirdly, you can use this filter in heavy light polluted skies. If you live in a city where you've got light blazing everywhere, you can use this filter to cut off the light pollution. Cities can be very hard to do astrophotography, but this filter makes it easier. How to use this filter? Well, this filter is available in many different sizes. For example, you can get one for your DSLR that snugs near your sensor. You can get one which is 1.25 inch. That will fit most eyepieces and nose pieces. The one I've got is 2 inch. The beauty of this is that I can put this on my field flattener like this. It easily screws in. So I can use this for both visual and astrophotography. If you're thinking of getting one, make sure you buy the one that matches your telescope. My telescope has 2-inch focuser, so this is perfect. Also, my use is primarily astrophotography, but this can be used for visual work as well. In terms of astrophotography, you can use a CCD camera or DSLR with this. Although you might already know, DSLRs are generally noisier and less sensitive than astro cameras. That said, it would still be usable with DSLRs. I've taken a few photos with my DSLR using this filter, and I'll show you at the end of this video how it looks. By the way, I have done a whole video on narrow band astrophotography with a stock DSLR. Check that out. Well, what about potential problems? Well, let me be clear, I have not personally experienced any problems with this filter. Let me tell you what I've read and heard about. Some have pointed out that this filter can cause internal reflection. Now, I think that's not really a problem with the filter, but instead the rig. You've got to make sure that your camera doesn't generally have this problem. And also, if possible, make sure this filter is not too close to the sensor. Well, others have highlighted and pointed out that the clip inversion of this filter is not as tight fit. It moves around. Now, I have other clip-in filters by Svbony, and I have not experienced any of that. That said, I don't own H-alpha filter in clipping form, so I can't really say for sure. I can confirm that this filter doesn't produce halos around the stars, in my limited experience. As I said, I don't really have any issues with this filter at all. Finally, let me show you some photos taken with this filter. Some of the photos are mine, others are taken by different people using this filter. Overall, I think this filter does a great job. It's very reasonably priced, excellent quality, and nice built. It's quite narrow at 7nm, and it makes astrophotography easy at night when the moon is up. This can be used for terrible light-polluted skies. It has many uses. So what do I think about this? Well, I think this is a great filter, and I'm very positive about it. I don't have any complaints whatsoever, so I will highly recommend this to you. Hey, if you found this video to be helpful, please subscribe. If there's anything I've not covered or overlooked, please feel free to comment below.